You've probably seen the ads for them. Spit in a test tube, send it to a company such as 23andMe or Ancestry.com, and in return, you'll find out what your genetic ethnicity is, with you being able to see if your ancestors came from regions such as Europe, East Asia, or Sub-Saharan Africa, for example. In 2018 alone, people taking DNA ancestry tests exceeded that of all previous years combined, with 26 million people sending their DNA to companies such as 23andMe and Ancestry.com. 100 million people are estimated to analyze their ancestral background in the next 2 years through such DNA ancestry services. So how are these companies analyzing your ancestral history from your spit? DNA is made up of two coils which wrap around each other to form a double helix. Our DNA is made up of molecules called nucleotides, which contain a phosphate group, a sugar group, and a nitrogen base. It is the nitrogen part which determines our genetic code, with there being four types, A, T, G, and C. DNA in humans is 99.5% the same across all of us, which means that these DNA genetic ethnicity tests are looking at the remaining 0.5%, which is about 600,000 of the 3 billion bases in our DNA. Single nucleotide polymorphisms, or SNPs, are the most common types of genetic variation between us. An example of differences in DNA is that you may have a nucleotide of T in a certain stretch of DNA where someone else has a C nucleotide. These SNPs are passed down between generations, which means the more SNPs you have in common with someone, the more likely it is you share a similar and more recent ancestry. Services such as 23andMe and Ancestry.com compare your SNPs to a reference population of their own. 23andMe, for example, has 11,091 people who they've chosen to be a part of their reference dataset. The likes of 23andMe compare your SNPs to SNPs in their reference populations, which are categorized by locations in which those SNPs are more common across their dataset. 23andMe, for example, looks at your SNPs compared to 45 reference populations to see which segments of your DNA closely matches that of the different segments in their 45 reference populations, and then assigns their ancestry to the corresponding segment of your DNA. They then do this for all the individual segments, add them together, and compute your overall ancestry composition. An example is the maternal haplogroup H, which as you can see in this worldwide distribution graph, is very common to Europe, but it is rare to those native to Australia or the Americas. This means if you have this specific marker, there is a decent chance that you have at least one European ancestor who has passed this on. Obviously, just using one DNA marker isn't very useful, but this sort of technique is used across hundreds of thousands of DNA markers, using reference populations to see what markers are more common in different populations. There are a few downsides to how the likes of 23andMe and Ancestry.com do these genetic ethnicity tests. Reference populations for the most part are self-reporting their ancestry, meaning there is a chance of error there. There is also not a consistent amount of people in the reference populations across the world. There are not as many African people in the reference populations compared to the likes of Europe, which has a much larger reference population, which means some results may not show up in your results or not be very precise due to there just not being enough data to properly pinpoint. But these services have been greatly increasing their reference populations in all areas in the past few years. This means that your results over time will change due to there being more people added to the dataset, meaning there are more SNPs to compare you to. All of these services, such as 23andMe and Ancestry.com, are also using different datasets, which means you could get different results between the two services. Some people have seen one of them report that they are 9% Greek, for example, while the other reports 28%. Which is a fairly large difference. There is also the discussion on privacy, with us sending our DNA to private companies in which they could use how they want, but that is a fairly long discussion. Thanks for watching, and be sure to subscribe.